frivolity. Selfish anarchists trampling their responsibilities into salacious mud. A disgusting indulgence of mindless rhythmical repetition pummeling away at the very fabric of our society. It undermines us all. They are pulling at the threads of this fabric until it loosens itself into the slackness of nighttime hedonism. They have no regard for our future or our past. They just indulgently pull on this fabric in the misguided hope that it will eventually fray and break. I say it has been more than enough. I remain alert constantly. I'm not afraid of ones I see, and with a policy of constancy, I enter the fray consciously. I loom above these frayed threads, ready to reweave the fabric of our society into its former glory. We will return this country to its rightful place, standing magnanimously above all other nations. We, who have worked hard and sacrificed while they dance their nights away into further insignificance, we, who continue to work hard and sacrifice while they awake with a devilish anger focused on the destruction of all we hold dear. This is why dancing must be illegal, for this is what it does. A lustful embrace with the devil followed by protracted rest. And now is not the hour to rest. Now is the hour of maximum danger, requiring the greatest respect for the rule of law. In the face of flailing limbs and loose moles and all the anarchist destruction that they carry in their wake, I do not shrink from this responsibility. I remain awake to it. I am not afraid of what I see. I enter the fray consciously. For the faith and devotion which we bring to this endeavor will light our country and all who serve it, and the glow from that fire will truly light the world.
Thank you. of a certain Frau Trophia, who one day in 1518 went down to the riverbank in Strasbourg and began to dance. She danced alone and no music could be heard. She seemed to be in her own world, moving frenetically to the rhythms in her head for apparently several days. Gradually, the townsfolk began to gather around, mesmerized by her performance. And one by one, they joined in until there was a heaving mass dancing on the riverbank. Non-stop, day and night. The riverbank became drenched in blood as the dancers' feet blistered and split. And by the time the dancing frenzy was over, somewhat 30 days later, dozens had dropped dead. And no one knows why Frau Trophia started to dance on the riverbank, or what caused hundreds of people to join in with her. But this story is not unique. There are many stories of similar dancing plagues throughout history.
What a fantastic job they've done for us.